Hey, hello, welcome to the second part of my centrifugal deseparator build video. In the first video, I built this separator out of acrylic tube you can buy in Europe. In this video, I will build the base plate, take you to the design process of that and all the functions it needs to fulfill. Also, I will show you how I fitted my waste bins in the design. To make that easy was not simple. So, let's dive in. The next phase of the build is the base plate, and that has several functions to fulfill. It needs to hold all the parts together and facilitate cutouts for the dust to go through to the waste bins. It also needs to fix the waste bins into place with an airtight seal so the dust will not escape. I like the design to be lightweight because my planer is in another location than my studio. So, it needs to be easy to handle and assemble. And it also needs to look great. And all those points were a little bit overwhelming at first. So, I started with solving the problems one by one. And to integrate them would be a problem for later. I designed the dust boards for easy assembly of the straps. And you need 4 of them to fix each tube into place. And they have a square hole in them for the carriage bolt to fit into. And when you assemble them, they are a little bit too short. So the PLA will deform when you tighten the screws. Downside of that is that the deformation is permanently. So reusing the strap is not that effective anymore. For the material of the base plate, I use 3/4 inch popular plywood. And in Dutch it's called timmerplaat. It's a softwooding sheet type that is easy to work with and very lightweight. So to mount all the parts of the separator on it, you first need to cut out the holes for the dust boards and the carriage bolts. To do that, you can reprint the dust boards again, only then for the first few layers. And use it as a template to mark out all the holes and use a drill and a jigsaw to cut them out. I instead use a handheld CNC router that I show you later on in this video. Back in January, the hardest part for me was to find a solution for the waste bins. To make that as simple as possible, lightweight and easy to change. And at first I looked at the Euro-style containers that I use a lot throughout my shop for storage. And you also have them in a closed handle version. Only they are not transparent. And I like to see the dust amount that is filling inside of the box. I also was thinking about making the dust bins myself, out of wood and acrylic. And the advantage of that would be that I can make the dust bins each a different size. And the separator has 2 stages, and the first stage is about 80% of the dust that will be filtered out there. So the second dust bin for the second stage only needs to be 20% of the size. Only then I thought about, what would Vestool do? I really like the T-lock design of the sustainers. They are very easy to unlock and to lock, and they are strong. Only how can we integrate something in the design of our waste bins? That will be the challenge. So Vestool, they make their own waste bins for their cyclone style pre-separators. Only these bins are very expensive for a piece of plastic. Only it's a proven design and they are very strong, with strong handles on it. And there is a 3-pack available for these containers. And I managed, after a long search on the internet, to buy 3 of them for 80 euros without VAT. And that's a nice price for me to go with this design. I think we can use this handle to slide into a kind of wedge that lifts the waste bin up and close the gap between the waste bin and the base plate with some kind of compression tape between it. On the other half, we only need to lift it a little bit up and lock it into place with the T-lock. So I went to CAD and made a kind of wedge with chamfers on it, so it is self-aligning. And when you push it further back, the waste bin is lifted up to close the gap. on the other half, I made a piece of PLA that fills up the whole gap and has the receiver of the T-lock to it. To see the complete T-lock design, we need to go back in time to the PVC version of the separator. The male adapter fits into the handle of the waste bin and the female adapter is screwed into the base plate. You can put the handle into it and when you turn it, the waste bin is lifted a little bit up. This time I need to do a better job because I added this later and cutting the wood with the multi-tool damaged the dustport in doing so. So the only thing we need to solve now is to make sure that we have an airtight seal between the waste bin and the base plate. And for that, my first option was compression tape, a small version that was put in a very nicely cut groove that has exactly the same shape as the waste bin. Only after a day, that was a complete disaster because the stress in the tape was too high and the tape was coming loose. So plan B it was. I take the 5 cm wide compression tape and put it straight onto the base plate. And that didn't look nice, but it worked pretty good. All the parts of the puzzle are complete now, so we can go to CAD to make one complete integrated design of it. In Fusion, I added the cutouts for the dust ports, carriage bolts and the handles to the top view of the part. The Shaper plugin can export the solid body and convert it into a vector file that contains cutting information and depth settings. I'm going to use my Shaper Origin to cut out a file we just made in Fusion 360. This is not a fully automated CNC machine. You still need to move the tool by hand, and only the very fine adjustment of the spindle is automated for you. I like it a lot and I use a Shaper system since 2020 now. So to be clear, nothing in my shop is sponsored or gifted to me. I bought this one in 2023 and it's the version 2 of the Shaper Origin. It has a better quality camera in it and that upgrade I like a lot. The tool uses its camera to define the workspace and it needs special tape to do so. The tape has domino style print on it and you can randomly tape it onto the plywood. I use my caliper at the end to make a clean cut, because when a little piece of the domino print is missing, that domino will not be recognized anymore. You need to start a new scan and move the tool slowly around, so the camera has time to scan the complete worksheet. Finish the scan and create a new virtual grid. For that you need to lower the router a bit, so it can touch the sides of the worksheet on 3 places. You need to touch on 2 places at the front and 1 place at the side. That defines the worksheet 0 and then you can import the file we made in Fusion. That can be placed easily on the right spot by moving the tool. You can zoom out for a last check and then we can go to cut. The dotted line shows the cut direction and before we can start we need to zero the tool with the Z-touch. Attach the hose and dust cover and manually turn on the motor. Slowly guide the circle of the router on the cut line and the tool automatically stays on that line. When you move too much from the line, the router retracts as fast as possible to save your workpiece. For the straight faces on the outside of the base plate, I use my plunge cut saw. That saves the router bit and has a clean cut without the need to run a finishing pass with the router. So the whole base plate is ready now. We only need to sand it a little bit before we can mount all the parts of the separator on it. And yes, I made a rookie mistake by not changing the tube length to the real dimension. Luckily, it hit me just in time to not make a big mess of it. I pre-drilled the holes for a better fit of the carriage bolts To tighten the straps, I use a double M6 nut in the socket wrench with the washer on top and tighten it by hand. The extra nut acts only as a spacer in the socket. Gently tighten all the nuts and place the dustbin on top to mark its position. This will help you with placing the compression tape into the right spot. I made some spacing blocks that guide the dustbins always in the right place to line up for the twist locks. Eyeball the hinge in the center of the dustbin and screw one side into place. Then mount the T-lock latch and press the hinge down before you tighten the last screw so the bin is pressed into the compression tape. As a bonus feature, I made some French cleats for it, so we are able to hang it on the wall now. I reprinted the in and the outlet and the Y pieces, so they need less material to print now. And in the next video, I will make a hose adapter for it and we can start testing. And for this video, the main question is, how easy are the dustbins to change? Let's find out. I think that is easy. So do you have a small shop with big tools? And is this the separator you want to build for your own shop? All the files are for free on my GridUp site. That was it for this video. I hope you enjoyed and I see you in the next video. Houdoe!